buying the book is an act of defiance. Getting the book is a pro. If you want to piss Care off, you'll get this book. You have to first learn everything and then share it within your...
Yeah, but here's what you're up against, and you know this. George W. Bush comes out shortly after 9/11 and says Islam is peace. You know, people like me grew up seeing Muhammad Ali, who was a boxer, or Ahmad Rashad, who was a sportscaster, or Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, who was an NBA player, and we liked them. We cheered them on. We had no problem with who they were, that they changed their names and joined some other religion. We've got this overwhelming left media pushing the idea this is a peaceful religion. All of the violent passages in the Hadith and in the Sharia law were undone by what they said later, when you and I both know actually the peaceful passages were undone by the violent ones that were added later, and that's the way it goes, right? So how do you combat that when the leader of the free world, and then you had Obama, who was like really pro-Islam? What do you do? I mean, because people really believed them.
Well, listen, that's why the role of the individual is so important. If history has taught us anything, is that the individual can change the course of human events. Look, I can tell you that after President Trump was elected, things got very tough for us. Why? Because they have, you're right, they have music, media, academia, the movies, they have the culture in a chokehold. So how did President Trump get elected? They got elected by people like you and me. And the left blamed my website and my social media and my colleagues and talk radio. And so now they're trying to shut us down on social media. Look, my news feed has been blocked from my 1.2 million followers. Google AdSense terminated my account. No more Google Ads.
Crazy.
And they have a monopoly. YouTube deleted my channel. Pinterest, you can't share my links. Look, it's a war. It's a war in the information battle space. I can't impress this upon you enough. And every single person must do their part. There are no casual observers. You must educate everyone in your sphere of influence. We must build an army of Davids against this Goliath. Yes, it is an enormous, this leftist Islamic machine is enormous and very well funded. But we know what happened with David and Goliath. We know we can win. But there are no casual observers. Look, there's a right side and there's a wrong side, Joe. There's good and there's evil. And being in the middle, sitting on the fence, is evil. You are aiding and abetting the enemy. People have to get active. That's why I recommend this book, because it's the story of how an everyday New York City career girl went from, you know, loving her life, her music, her art, going from, you know, glam girl to the country's, you know, most racist, Islamophobic, anti-Muslim bigot. Right?
The fact that, I was going to say, that's what people actually say about you, but I love that you embrace it and throw it back at them. We've got to go. I know how busy you are, and I really appreciate you taking the time. But one thing you said really did jump out at me. People are sitting in the middle. Just like in San Bernardino, all the neighbors said, we saw people in traditional Muslim garb going in and out of this garage where there were loud noises in the middle of the night at 2 and 3 o'clock in the morning. We thought something was going on, but we didn't report it because we don't want to be called Islamophobic. That's dumb. That's actually deadly. So I love that you're unafraid. The book is called Fatwa, Hunted in America. It's published next week, November 1st, but you can pre-order it right now at Amazon and Barnes & Noble. Go to PamelaGeller.com and go check out everything that she does. Pamela, thanks a million. I really appreciate the time.
Thank you, Joe.
Talk soon. We're back after this in the Joe Pags Show. Stay right here.
The land of the free honors the bravest of the brave. For their sacred pledge to protect our freedoms,